And we're back with part 5 of Dark Souls. Is this part 5? Sure, whatever. Part 5 of Dark Souls, Prepare to Die. On the PC. Try jumping. And who is this rascal? Who is this dashing rapscallion? He wants a hug. I want to kick him so bad.
Greetings.
Thou art a friend. Oswald of Karim. Thou art a friend.
Cometh thou to confess? Put your king. For indeed, your sin is my domain.
Well. Get out of here, Frollo. I've had enough of your Swedish antics for one day. So he sells a variety of things, and he's related, well, not like a familial tie, but he is a servant, a vassal, if you like, of, sure, it's by an indictment, of the goddess Velka. And I almost said Velik, which is a different game entirely. So we can use him to, if we've sinned, which we haven't, because Sivamont's a good boy, we can request absolution. For a cost of souls. Abandoning Covenant, yeah, you can do that too.
How honorable of you.
He's a strange one. So something that rather irritates me, but, you know, I understand it from a gameplay perspective. You can clearly survive this drop. It's not to that little thing there. That is not a... I mean, sure, in real life it would probably break your face, but you can survive that distance in game. But if you drop here, you die. And I think that's kind of stupid, as that would be a really good shortcut. But it also means you could do it to, like, bug out the bosses. So, you know. And, we are not going to kill Lautrec. Lautrec. We're not going to kill him because, well, we're going to kill him in Anor Rodeo. What? So, here we have... an interesting dance and, more importantly, we have a shortcut back to Firelink Shrine. The first... more or less the first. And there's a little village, town down there, which you can't access, but you can have a look at. Now, at one point I thought that was actually New Londo, but then I realised that would be impossible, because New Londo is, in a cavern. Oh, what a... terrible jump. I'm not good at platforming. I'm really not. And it's even worse in Dark Souls, especially when my frame rate keeps going absolutely bonkers and I have no idea why. I know, I need to stop complaining about the frame rate. Hell, I played on the console version, so... and here's another naked guy. Let's go... let's take ourselves to 18 vitality and 18 endurance. We should be able to equip some stuff now. No? Huh, whatever. We're not gonna wear that. So Lautrec does drop a very nice ring, but we're not going to get it from him. Not yet.
Why, what a surprise. I didn't expect you to make it. Oh, somebody rang the bell. Wait, was it you? You never give up, do you? Well, don't stop now. Don't you ever think to... you... Unless you had...
Anything else to say?
What's wrong? No problem. Have a seat and get comfortable. We'll both be hollow before you know it.
And there's the bird that brought us here, over the wall. Anything to say, Fatty?
Oh, hello? Very well.
No? Okay, whatever.
Come again?
No. Sivamont does not come on command. And here he is, the golden boy. You can tell he's going to be our rival because he's gold. We're not silver, but we should be. And we probably will be.
Ah, hello there. I have your reward.
So why does he have a sunlight medal when he's not... Well, what a sneaky guy.
I am grateful to you for...
Yeah, that's not suspicious at all.
For you.
You rascal.
You again. Our futures are murky.
Oh. Dressy. So, the Firekeeper soul we picked up in the church, we now can use to... reinforce our Estus flask, which makes it heal more health. Which is, you know, it's always good.
Our futures
are... Oh, be like that, you stressy little git. Right, so... normally I would go straight down to Blight Town from here, but... I'm gonna try and do every area, so... it would be the Depths next. That'll be fun. And for that, we must first visit the Lower Undead Burger King. But first, we're gonna upgrade ourselves a little bit. Because upgrading your weapons is very, very, very important in this game. And we're gonna kill... we'll make one quick round of the church and see if we can get a side sword. You know, a shield would be nice too, but, you know... I'll use a longsword if I have to, it's no big deal. I'm planning on going more dex than strength, so, a side sword would be better as it scales with dex, not strength. But, it's not too important at the start of the game. Yeah. Rather surprising range, to be honest, on some of their attacks. Rather surprising. Oh. Ah. I forgot he doesn't actually have a side sword, but he gave us a shard, which is what we need to upgrade. Oh, I thought I could hear a little hollow. He's just being irritating, to be honest. By himself, he's no threat, but he can easily stun us or something, because we have no poise, really. Here we go. You never want to get surrounded in Dark Souls. I guess if you have huge poise, it's not so important. Whoops. Screwed that up. Let's back off a bit. Now this guy is very annoying. Let's so we'll get rid of him first. How about a side sword? You tit. Two-handing your weapons increases the damage of backstabs, but I believe that's only if they have a strength modifier to begin with. And it has a descaling with strength, which I don't know if that counts or not, but whatever. One more here. I hate that shield swipe, it's very fast. Ah! That was a partial parry, which means you take less damage, but you don't get the riposte animation, per se. Well, no shield, no sword. That's unfortunate, but, you know, whatever. Oh dear. That was... That's Dark Souls for you. You can get, like, 5 parries in a row, and then you'll just get absolutely demolished by a starting enemy. We will have some poise soon, so we'll be okay. Actually, I think we'll go and get that now, as we don't have any other ring. Yeah, we'll go and get the ring that will give us some poise. That'll really help us out. Poise is, frankly, quite overpowered, as it means you can just kind of steamroll through the game, but I don't want to be dying too much, as the occasional death is kind of funny, but if you just keep dying, no one wants to watch someone do the same crap all over again, you know? So we'll get some poise to help us out. You rascal, you killed me last time. I ain't happy about that. Overkill. It's, as we're here, we'll do another quick round of Borders. So, I'll be uploading these videos every day at 5 PM GMT. That's, well, that's mid-morning for those in the west coast of America, and around lunchtime for those on the east coast. It's early morning for Japan and Australia. You know, I think most of my viewers are in Europe, so... But, leave me a comment, tell me where you're from, so I can come and stab your country. Nah, the only country I really want to stab is Sweden. Sweden's... Yeah. We'll talk more about Sweden one day. Hey, jerkface, give me your sword. Right in the dick. Ah! Farming in this game can be very frustrating. It can also be relaxing if, you know, it depends on your mindset. Sometimes it's relaxing to just play some Dark Souls, grind for a bit, you know? Like, I used to do that in, World of Warcraft on my friend's mage. I'd just hop on and go to, I don't even remember. It was the first expansion for World of Warcraft. They added all these, elemental sort of items. And you could sell them on the auction house, and I'd go and grind them for a bit. It was relaxing.
Well, Harold, you seem to need it.
Let's see, what have you got for us to buy? We'll take it. We'll take it, and we'll take it. Battle axe. One of my favourite weapons, but we're not going to use it on this character. We shall upgrade our longsword. And we will upgrade our lapierre. Actually, yeah, we'll upgrade it to a +5, but not go further than that. And now, as I'm here, I want to do a little bit of... There we go. We'll use these items to get ourselves some more souls. Gosh, I'm sure I had something else to talk about, but I've completely forgotten it, you know? Which is not a good sign. I'm trying to keep these videos within 30 minutes to an hour, sometimes a bit less, but I don't want to go too high because the way I'm recording this, the files are absolutely massive. When I record on my Xbox using my PVR, I can encode those as I record, but I can't do that on the PC because it would give me a pretty huge performance hit. So I'd rather just have bigger files.
You need any?
Okay, it's quite a few more. And we have one left. We'll use that. No, we won't. We'll use that later.
Don't get yourself. Neither of us.
Yeah. Huh? So you can kill this guy whenever you want, but we're gonna leave him for now. As he has nothing we want, nothing we need. And here we have Darkroot. Is it Darkroot Garden or Basin? No, this is Garden, yeah. You know, I forget if you can actually backstab the trees. That's a really... You think that would be obvious, but... Ooh. That was close. These guys have very long range, and Oh. And they drop lots and lots and lots of moss, which we use to remove build-up of bleeding, remove build-up of poison, and toxic. And of course, you can actually remove toxic and poison with them once they're equipped. Oh yeah! Lots and lots of hidden secrets in this game. There's actually one bonfire that I only found out after I'd played the game for about 500 hours in, I believe, is it in Lost Izalith? Or is it in... I can't actually remember. I think it's in Lost Izalith or the Demon Ruins. I never remember which of those zones is which. Oh, right, I remember what I was going to do. I remember now. I was going to bump up the brightness a bit. As I remember, some of the videos came out very dark on YouTube. And I want you guys to be able to see what I'm doing. Oh, should we go for the Moonlight Butter douche? You know what? Yeah, let's do it. And then, as this is getting a bit long, so yeah, that'll do. That will do nicely. Oh, and we can get some slightly better items up here. But let's hope we don't get invaded. It might be funny, but I'm really not equipped to deal with invaders. I can barely deal with the game itself. You coming? Yeah, of course you are, you douches. It might not be so noticeable, seeing as we've moved on to stronger enemies, but even taking your weapon from a plus, well, from 0 to plus 5 makes a big, big difference. Especially on the gargoyles. Oh, hello. This person looks funny, let's summon them. I'm probably gonna summon people if I see them, just, you know, because the more you summon people, the more antics you can have. And there's always time for antics. And here we have the Partisan, which is a really cool PvP weapon. At least I think it is. One of the weaknesses spears have, many of them can only thrust, they have no way to sweep. Which might not seem that important, but sweeping attacks are very important in this game. You want to be able to hit up and down, left and right, and so forth. Ooh, can we sneak past him? We can, and he didn't even see us. Summoning failed, but here we have Witch Beatrice. She's hidden behind some bushes. And she can be very helpful for the Moonlight Butterfly, because we have no ranged attack other than our bow, which hits like a baby's punch. Not a baby nail, though. And she hits like a truck. A magical bullet truck. And here, over here, we have the most famous set of armor. Is it famous? Well, it's like the... It is the flagship armor of Dark Souls, you know? The Elite Knight set, it's what they wear on the cover and all that. Alright, Beatrice, blast these fools with your giant stick. What are you doing? Hey, you might as well come over here. Such amazing pathing in this game. I'm just trying to get Beatrice to kill these guys for me, because she doesn't want to come out here because she's being dumb. These guys don't drop anything we need, but they can give nice stuff. Nice experience points. Experience points? God, I'm talking about a different game. They give good souls. And you get to see their great physics. Oh, stop getting stuck in the tree, you douchebag. So, you see he just cast an AoE spell. Which means we can't roll. You can also cast that spell yourself, and it used to be insanely overpowered in PvP when the game first came out. Okay, let's go. Up to the Moonlight Butterfly. Very Very nice looking boss, but a very boring boss. There he is. What the... OMG. It's Carl the Knight. Oh, he's gone. Carl, come back. Oh yeah, and here's the armor we got. I imagine you know what it looks like, but... but we fat roll, so we're not going to wear that. We'll wear the greaves, and we'll stick with our standard helm. Oh, for real? That's... I guess I'm way too used to the, thingy. Ring of Favor and Protection. Fapping ring. Fap ring. Oh, we're gonna quickly swap to... Wooden shields have good magic defense quite often. So we're gonna equip this. And we're literally just gonna let Beto smash this guy. Now, funnily enough, there is actually another model of Beatrice in the game files, which is like a lolly version of her or something, where she's like tiny and stuff, which is pretty weird, but who knows why that's there. Horoshaw, split it wide open. Yes, split it wide open with your stick, you silly witch. Bye-bye. I really like Metal Gear Revengeance. No, Metal Gear Rising... Is it Metal Gear Rising Revengeance? That's a tongue twister, no mistake. And here's an Andre I like. And we'll take it, we'll take it all. And we'll swap back to our heater shield. Speaking of shields, if you've been following Dark Souls 2 information, you'll know that they've been holding a contest to for fans such as you and I to design shields for the game. It'd be good if we could jump down there, but so they had three different templates for Japan, Europe, and America, and as it happens, my entry was the highest voted European shield of all the entries. Mine had the most votes, which means I don't believe it's confirmed to be in the game in Dark Souls 2, but I do believe that being first place, and you can see this tree has moved and it's not actually a tree. What? Oh dear. Good thing about headphones, I heard that. Oh, this guy is gonna be a right rascal to kill. No, 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 don't do that. No, that's not good. But yeah, the winners, I believe, are going to be announced on July 18th, 2013. It's, ooh, if I say the date, you'll know when I'm recording this, which should be really sneaky, so I won't say the date, but... July 18th is soon, at any rate. Oh, don't come up here, you little red thing. No, why are you coming? What are you doing? What are you doing? No, go away. Get out of here. Shoo. Ah, the tree is chasing me too. What is this? Get out of here, you weirdo thing. So the tree is trying to block our way. What was I saying about? Oh yeah, the shield. Kaboom. So even though I had the most amount of votes, what they're doing is they were sending the top 30 with the most votes into off to From Software in Japan, and then they would choose, I believe, 2 from each category, 6 altogether, and put them into the actual game, Dark Souls 2. So there was a lot of drama at the time. Like, a lot of shields were plagiarized, a lot were just Google images that had been copy-pasted, and, you know, all that sort of nonsense. And there were a few people trolling. And, you know, they were saying, like, oh, you copied the Russian coat of arms. And I was like, what? I had a look, and apparently Russians invented phoenixes, even though it was actually an eagle on the Russian thing, and my shield was a phoenix, but whatever. But yeah. Mine was a nicely hand-drawn shield. Black and gold of a phoenix. And, you know, I like black and gold, I really do. There was also some drama about ENB's shield, because he didn't design it, but someone else designed it and sort of did it in his name, which, you know, was very sneaky, as, in my opinion, that is simply riding somebody else's popularity, and I think it's a sneaky, lame thing to do, but, you know, whatever. If he wins, good for him. If he wins, he should really be giving whatever prizes he gets to ENB, you know, I mean, because people were voting not for him, but for ENB's, but, you know, that's just life. We don't need anything from Andre at the moment. Let's see, I think we're going to call it here, and I will see you tomorrow, as will Civimon. Ciao. Oh, you rascal. What are you doing? Don't hit me. What a little git. Okay, bye.